Hello and welcome to my video from Stockholm in Sweden. I thought I'd put a little video together just to show everyone back on what I'm up to over here. Show you all a little bit of the city and you know where I'm living and everything. So we'll start off with a tour of my bedroom, which is where we are right now. Okay, so that's my view out over Professorlingen and Lapis here. Now this is my little desk where I can sit and do some reading and stuff like that. A few photos from back home. Okay, and this is my desk where all the magic happens. I do my studying here, all that sort of stuff. Yeah, mum, photo of you there. Where's the steak shack? And a few more photos. Okay, and then there's the bathroom, which is fairly pokey, but it does the job. And there's my bed. Okay, so that's my room. Okay, here's the common room. So I'm living here on this corridor with about 10 other people. So we all share this area, the dining table, couches to sort of chill. And this is our kitchen. It's pretty massive really, and it's pretty good if you can get in here when there's only a couple of people. Lots of room, a bit more than back home. So yep, that's the kitchen and common room.
You hear that? It wakes up at 8 o'clock every morning at the moment. Sucks.
Okay, so this is like the central part of Lapis. See the shop over there? It's a gym just down there. We restaurant. Whole bunch of rooms. It just keeps going all the way up there. It's a massive place. Up there.
National elections in about 2 days' time, so you got these stalls and posters absolutely everywhere. You got Nya Moderna Moderata, Folkpartiet, Moderna Sierra Savage, that's like their Green Party, and the Social Democrats.
This is the Tunnelbana. It's the way the Swedes get around in Stockholm. And I'm using it every day to get back to town and back home and everything, and here comes one now. They're pretty huge.
This is now in Södermalm, which means south something in Swedish. This is Yorkatan Street. It's been pedestrianised for quite some time now, so it just means that there's no cars. You can just walk up and down it. It's pretty cool. That place up there with gondolin on it is apparently a restaurant. It's up there, which is quite expensive. It's got the views over the harbour, over that way. So we're now in Slusen, which is basically at the top of Södermalm. So it's just near Gamlestan, which you've also seen. It's Gamlestan over there. That truck's there representing one of the political parties. So you can see how crazy these Swedes go with their politics.
Okay, this is one of the more iconic spots in Stockholm. At least for those who have read the Stieg Larsson book. Like the girl with the dragon tattoo. This is now Valmansgatan. So up there, somewhere, is where Mikael Blomqvist lived in the book. So here's the sign for it there. Valmansgatan number 1. Nice cobbled street. So this is one of the more
KTH or Kungliga Högskolan. I've got a couple of my classes up here, one this semester and one next, and it's
It's one of the bigger universities in Stockholm, a lot bigger than my one. It's like the technical school, so it's got all sorts of sciences and engineering and all that sort of stuff. And yeah, it's a very, very small part of it.
That's the Stockholm School of Economics. That's where I'm studying at the moment, or Handelshögskolan I Stockholm, in Swedish.
That there is usually filled with water. It's quite a nice shot over the water onto the school, but unfortunately, when it gets into winter, it freezes over, so I've got to empty it out. It's a bit ominous that that's actually been emptied already. It's a public library up there. It's really nice inside. It's sort of like a big...
Funny story. I just got out of a business presentation, and half of it was in Swedish, so that was cool.
Stockholm on the other side of the world, and I look forward to seeing you all again soon. I hope everything's going well back at home or wherever you are in the world. Alright, see ya.